Okay, we are live on YouTube, so we want to start going. If this is Heather Riggs with the New England Museum Association. I'm Director of Administration. Here, welcome joining us today. We have quite a few people on the line. So if you guys just want to put in the chat feature, make sure you do it to all. There's a little drop-down menu before you start typing. So all panelists and attendees, so we can see exactly where you guys are all viewing us from, because I know we have a lot of people outside of New England joining us today, which is awesome and amazing. And I want to welcome you guys all, and that's great. Yeah, so make sure when you do all panelists and attendees, so we can so everybody could see it. That would be great. So I'm going to turn it over to my colleague Meg Winnicade. She's Director of Engagement here at NEMA, and she will get the ball rolling.
All right, hi everybody. Thank you so much for being here with us this afternoon. I suspect that a lot of us have been spending a lot of time on conference calls. So I'm going to give you a quick overview of the plan for today. And then in order to get everybody up and moving and get the blood up back into your brain from wherever it may have settled to on your last several hours of video chats, et cetera, we will be starting with a dance break. So the plan for today is we will be starting with a little bit of a dance party to get ourselves warmed up. Then I have several creative activities for you to do, little 5-minute creative breaks, both writing and visual art based. So we've got sort of a combo verbal and photography challenge to start, a writing challenge, a doodle challenge, etc. And then we will be exiting with another dance break. So I would like to invite you to participate by contributing whatever it is that you're writing into the chat feature, or you can take photographs of things you're creating, et cetera, and tweet them to us. Use at NEMANet to tag us here at NEMA and also the hashtag creative break. That would be awesome. I won't be able to see them myself until the end of the session, but Heather will be keeping an eye on it. And we would love to see what you guys come up with in the next half hour to 45 minutes or so. So thank you again so much for being here. And we will start with our creativity against cabin fever. So here are ways to get in touch with us, just in case I went through that too fast. If you want to reach out directly to me on Twitter, I am at mwinnicates, and to reach out to us here at NEMA is at NEMANet. And next we will be starting with our dance break. Now, please do not worry about any judgmental coworkers, your toddlers and your cats have probably been dying all day for you to get up and dance with them. So here we go. I picked this song because it has imagery in it that really reminds me of some of the artwork that we have in our museums and images of historical figures and things like that and what they might be saying and thinking and feeling while we are all away and sharing a certain amount of communal anxiety. So here we go. I'm going that way again.
I know change is a bad thing. Breaks me down into a sorry, sad thing. Not some iridescent, grateful butterfly. I'll resist with defiance, not the valor of a mystic silence. I will fight the dizzy spiral of goodbye. And it's alright, it's alright, it's alright. It's alright, it's alright, it's alright. Just don't say you don't love me. Never dangle any sword above me. With the kind of change that severs me in two. Give me amberizing glasses. Could you slow it down like molasses as I salvage my old self away from you? Oh, it's alright, it's alright, it's alright. It's alright, it's alright. It's alright, it's alright, it's it's alright, because I have seen insane things on those grand historic paintings, burning light on polished swords and burnished pride. Anxious smiles encased in whalebone, spines of steel from head to tailbone, cannons poised to blast the turning of the tide. It's a sad and a strange thing, but it's time and I am changing into something good or bad. Well, that's your guess. And my own sovereign nation, dedicated to a transformation, marching on with this target on my chest. Oh yes, it's alright, it's alright, it's alright. Oh, it's all right, it's all right, it's all right. It's all right, it's all right, it's all right. Oh, it's all right, it's all right, it's all right. It's all right, it's all right, it's all right. It's all right, it's all right, it's all right.
Okay, everybody, thank you so much. And I hope that got everybody's blood moving a little bit. I love her imagery about anxious smiles encased in whalebone. I don't know if anyone else has been having issues with anxiety and having a little trouble breathing, but that song always helps me get my breath back. So I hope it helped you as well. Now I would like to start with a moment of inspiration. This is a poem by Langston Hughes called Birth, and it was another one that made me feel really peaceful when I ran across it over this weekend and reminded me that we all have something to say, whether it's the peacefulness of a distant star or the craziness of a lightning flash, either way. So here is Birth by Langston Hughes. O fields of wonder, out of which stars are born, and moon and sun and me as well, like stroke of lightning in the night, some mark to make, some word to tell. And for our first activity, I would like to invite you to participate in a moment of discovery and try some found poetry using whatever books you happen to have nearby where you are sitting. If you are like many of the people I have been video chatting with, you have books either on view behind you or hidden off to either side. And so the way this works, this was originally inspired by a book by a woman named Nina Cacciadorian called Sorted Books, where she stacks books and uses the spines to tell a story. So this was one that I found that predates the current crisis, but I feel like speaks very nicely to the things we need to remind ourselves. So Gloria W. posted this on Flickr, and I am grateful to her for her three simple rules to give ourselves a little extra grace in this time, to be open to serendipity, and to act with common sense. And for my part, I would like you to remember the advice from my own library, which is where you live, inside or outside, all is fair, here and now and then. And at the end of the open road, victory! You're never weird on the internet. Almost. So I would like you to take the next 5 minutes to go scan your shelves and assemble a poem. Once you have got your story or poem assembled in a book stack, please take a picture and tweet it at us, or write your assembled stack of poetry into the chat feature so that we can all see and appreciate that. Thank you very much.
actually been going through the little libraries around my neighborhood and taking pictures of them, because the titles in that actually kind of lead up to an entire poem or kind of some kind of saying of some sort. So I've been watching those too.
That is fantastic. I have to admit that the fact that I have so many children's books in my house now leads to much more entertaining poetry, because between the fantasy and sci-fi titles and the Dr. Seuss titles and the picture book titles, you can come up with a lot of really entertaining stuff. So I have, for instance, in the current stack on the screen, a volume of poetry, a Cat in the Hat Learning Library Seuss-style science book, a Regency alternate history fantasy style book, Here and Now and Then, which is a time travel story, At the End of the Open Road, which is more poetry, Victory, which is more time travel, but also historical fiction set during the Napoleonic Wars, and then a memoir by Felicia Day, who is hilarious. And if you have not read You're Never Weird on the Internet Almost, I highly recommend it. All right, so we'll give folks another 2 minutes or so. And Heather, I can't see the chat feature terribly well while I'm in presenter view here. So if anybody is sharing some really fun book stacks in the chat, would you mind reading them out?
Yep, we have someone that mentioned that they have no books where they're working currently, but Market 32 has some good sales next week. Just a reminder of everybody to make sure you do all panelists and attendees when you type something in, so everybody else can see it, and just not the two of us. That would be great. So Mark did one, Already in Place, Hoot the Sheltering Sky, Black Hawk. And Lynn, yes, all the cameras and mics are muted on this because it's a webinar, so you're safe. Frank said, A Little Bit of Comedy. Susan is, How to Be an Explorer of the World. Melanie mentioned, I must admit that most of my available books are either from Audubon Society or Encyclopedias on Fish. Jan is Remembered Rapture.
All right.
Mine would be a little scary because there are more murder mysteries at the moment, so.
That's all right, Heather. Everybody needs a little bit of a dark sometimes too.
Yep, and then we have one
co-workers while you're still compiling your murder mysteries. We're all good, right?
Yeah. I guess I should start my video again. And then we have one to Buckle My Shoe. You should join us next week for our stay-at-home play date with adults. And then Sharon is At the Water's Edge, The Secret Garden, A Sound of Thunder, and The Wings of the Dove. A Humanist Vision, How to Be Lost. The Center Cannot Hold, The Man Who Mistook His Wife for Hat, Psych 101. We are all in that right now. Brooke is Brave New World, Death in the Air, Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, Transformations Coming Up for Air. And then John mentioned Longfellow, Irving's and Dickens. Then Michelle is Old Ways, Old Secrets. Lewis is, his are all Dickens. It's a goal. It's a good goal to have. You have the time now. Vanessa is Silent Cities. And then Susan's There Are More, How to Be Explorer of the World, Seeing What Others Don't, The Forest for the Trees, Out of Our Minds. Some of these are a little too close. So there's actually about 20 new messages, so I'm probably not going to go through all of them, but definitely read them and stuff like that. Some of them are good. Michelle has Old Ways, Old Secrets, Music Emotion, The Body Keeps a Score. Some of these are really Silent Cities, Zen Mind.
Very nice. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you all for playing along. And for our next moment, we have a doodle moment with a set of prompts brought to you by an artist named Z Darling, and I have linked to her blog here. So I liked this particular set of prompts for this month because most of them are extremely shelter at home friendly kinds of prompts. So you are welcome to doodle by day, today being the second. That would be doodle a toy, but you are also welcome to pick anything else on this list, and you have the next several minutes to grab a pencil or pen and piece of paper and do a doodle, or 12 or 4 or however many you feel like.
Meg, would you be able to post some of the links that you have in the chat while people are doing their doodles?
Yes, probably. Let me see if I can figure out how to do that without destroying the... without destroying the PowerPoint itself.
So we have a repeat for directions if you want to just say it a little bit again.
Sure, absolutely. So this is a month worth of doodle prompts from the artist Z Darling, and you are welcome to go by day and do yesterday's and today's cake and toy, or pick anything else that appeals to you on this list. I picked ones, this particular set of prompts, because I felt like they were very stay-at-home friendly on the most part, and not too dark. If you just Google doodle prompts out there, some of them are, they're a little gothic for my taste for the current circumstances. So. All right, we'll give folks another minute to get to doodle. And in the meanwhile, yet one more reminder, if you feel like snapping a picture and tweeting it at NemaNet, we would love to see it. If you could use the hashtag creative break, that'll help everybody else find your wonderful creations. All right. And we will do the, I have a 19 month old and therefore I do a countdown, which is pencils down in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I hope you all enjoyed your doodle break and I look forward to getting to see which ones you picked. Heather, thank you very much for adding our tag in the chat again. I appreciate that. All right. Next, I would like to offer everyone a moment of escape. Whether or not you have been able to get outside very much, I know here in Massachusetts, at least, it has been excessively rainy in the last several days, which has made for some very stir-crazy people. So I am inviting you to, at this point, look around and pick a piece of art that you may have hanging nearby, a photograph, a painting, etc., that depicts a view that you love, whether that's a different interior or an exterior. And if you are without a beautiful view, have no fear, because I have one for you on the next slide. So I would like you to take some time to imagine yourself there and then pay attention to what kinds of sensory details you can fill in for yourself to really bring yourself into that other place. Write down 5 things that you can hear when you're there, 5 things that you see, 5 things that you smell or feel, and then pick a recurring thought or image to start tying them all together. One of my favorites is to use a poem title like "This Is What I Know," and then to really get myself into the embodiment of wherever it is that that place is and what it is that I know about it, or even here I am, and use those things to write something and put it all together. The rules are completely suspended for poetry. You can rhyme, you can narrate, you can list, you can repeat, you can do none of those things. It's your escape and you get to pick. So my condolences to Sarah Mullen with the 3-year-old. My 19-month-old is asleep, which is why I'm here and not running around the neighborhood. So here we go. If you are in need of a beautiful view, I am going to share this one with you. This is a print that I have hanging in my dining room called Homework by John M. Standish. I got it in Wellfleet last summer because it reminds me of the view from the cottage that I sometimes get to stay at on the Cape. And so when things get particularly stressful, I look at this image and I imagine myself back there on our beach on Indian Neck. So please enjoy, or go find your own view and have a chance to write for a while. When you have something that you are happy with or feel brave enough to share, please feel free to include it in the chat feature for everyone to enjoy. In the meantime, I will get you some ambient noise so you can enjoy some waves and birdsong. Thank you. Okay, everybody. I hope you enjoyed your moment of escape and that you had a chance to get to be elsewhere for a few minutes. If there are any things that you would like to read, have read aloud, that is, please feel free to type it into the chat feature. I did manage to figure out how to get it open while also having my screen set so that you can see the slides. So I would love to get to see and hear anything you felt like writing, or again, please feel free to tweet it to us at NemaNet, hashtag creative break. We've got a question from Drew asking, what is this? And I'm afraid I need a little more clarification, Drew, in order to be able to answer you. So if you could add in some more details about what your question actually refers to, that would be helpful. And while folks have a chance to type, if you feel like sharing anything, I will happily read those aloud. And for the rest of us, we will go forward to the moment of nature with a poem called Framing the View by Rena Espelot. She is a local poet who I have had the pleasure of hearing read and who has also offered some fantastic poetry writing workshops in the greater Boston area and at the Mass Poetry Festival. And before we get to that, thank you so much, Jacqueline, for stepping up. You are very brave and we are grateful. Jacqueline says, I am weightless and suspended, floating in a sea of color. The troubles of the ground cannot touch me here. And thank you very much for saying you have also tweeted that with the picture that prompted it. I will definitely go check that out. That sounds like a lovely moment of escape. So similarly, I picked this poem when I ran across it this weekend because it reminded me of the way I think all of us have an instinct to try to control things in our lives right now, given that so much is out of control, and that it's also a reminder that no matter what we do, certain things are going to be beyond us, and that we need to offer ourselves the same kind of forgiveness that exists in this poem. So this is Framing the View by Rena Espaillat. Frame the view, he says. Compose it between those pines out there and this rocky ledge. But in those far pines, the wind's a ceaseless flowing, and I hear loose rock shifting. In his photographs, everything falls to order later, like hushed reflections. But now, in real sun that spends its gold like water, every leaf is in revolt. Center it, he says, there, on the lake. And I think, teach me to nail this day shut. I may be crafty, but heart's focus is nowhere sight can follow. Down below pines that dive into wind-shattered, uncaught spaces. Copper bleeds into blue there. Time's rearranging what the lens gathers, like small stones, like shade, like a marriage. All right. And thank you to Sharon for sharing her poem. Pudgy feet, toes wiggling, crushing the soft green grass as the wind blows haphazard strands of auburn hair. Butterflies dance and a child's laughter holds me spellbound. That is an excellent escape. Thank you for that, Sharon. All right. And here is our last exercise pre-exit dance party. So I would like to invite you to have a moment of nature that actually exists nearby. We had our distant escape, and now I'm inviting you to look out a nearby window or at a houseplant or at a pet, any kind of natural object, and think about what does it have to say to you in this moment? Did it say something different from last month? What might it say to you tomorrow? What can you not see or know about it just by looking at it? And then I invite you to either continue to write a description of your natural object and your reflections on it, or go back to drawing and draw your natural object and then caption it with whatever words or phrases it brings to mind. So I will bring back the soft murmur and invite you to go have a look out a window or at a plant for the next few minutes.
Thank you.
All right, folks, and we are back. I hope you had a moment to take in some natural beauty of one sort or another. If anybody feels like, again, sharing your drawings or your reflections, please feel free to tweet them at us or add them in the chat. Same goes for you. If you are following along on YouTube, I have not forgotten you. Please participate via Twitter if you are interested, or leave a note in the video comments. We will go back and read them later. And I'm really looking forward to hearing what you've been up to on the other side of the screen. We have here reflections from a cat with a reminder that it is important to feed and love them when they want. Yes. You should listen because my claws are sharp. That is an excellent reminder from both cats and toddlers. All right. And just before we go, I would like to give everyone a couple of reminders in a last moment of amnesty, just in case any of you need to hear these words as badly as I have needed to tell them to myself in the last couple of weeks. First of all, we are all here because we are people with creative instincts, but if your anxiety overwhelms your ability to create, that's okay. If you have a shelf or a closet or a file folder or a notebook full of unfinished projects, that's okay. If family and laundry and groceries and jobs or the job loss are stressing you out, that's okay. If everyday survival is taking all of your energy, that's okay. You still deserve a creative break, and it's important to be as kind to yourself as you are being to others. Thank you all for all of the work that you are doing to keep yourselves whole and keep your organizations vibrant and keep your audiences entertained and everything else that museum people are doing in the current circumstances. Please remember to take a few breaths for yourself from time to time. With the excellent reminder from Vanessa, yes, thank you. Stay safe and wash your hands. One more reminder, Nima is posting other helpful information, webinars, et cetera, using the hashtag MuseumProfDev, as in professional development, on Twitter. Please feel free to also follow Creative Break, because we're continuing to post creative invitations on our Twitter feed as well. You can find us at NimaNet or on Instagram at Nima_conference, as well as NimaNet.org. You can find me at M.Winnicates on Twitter or at Meg.Winnicates on Instagram and M.Winnicates.com if you're interested in reading any of my currently available published fiction and poetry. And so anybody who has to hop off, please feel free to do so. We are now going to exit to another dance party, and I hope you enjoy.
Then the smoke fills the air and they start to yell. Every man feels the blow when the earth explodes. There's a look in their eyes like a wounded ghost. Never a time you fall. Face down in the dirt, I never will be fall. Don't be settles on the sky. Then you count who is left saying who survived. You never know whose goodbyes you'll have to send. Then tomorrow the march will begin again. Never a time you fall. Weary on your knees, I never will be far. Don't be afraid. I got
That's it, everybody. Thank you so much and have a good and creative afternoon.
Thanks, everybody, for attending. Thanks, Meg.